caught me finishing one of the elves' little present. What do you think? It's well, I've never been the best at knitting, but it's sort of a little scarf. I'm sure he'll be very grateful. Ah, yes, it's one of my favorite things to do, just sit by the fire and do some sort of craft. I find it most relaxing, especially with my husband out all night. He works so hard. I've actually just finished wrapping his present. I hope he likes it. I mean, it may be a little bit of a present for me as well. I got him a beard trimmer. I know. Is it a bit sort of obvious that maybe I'm getting a bit bored of the beard? Oh well. I got him some nice cozy socks as well. And a lovely fur jumper. So I'm sure he'll like that. Anyway, enough of my rambling. What's made you stumble into here? Trouble sleeping. Too much excitement on Christmas Eve. Bless you. Well, I was just sat by the fire and getting myself all cozy, so you are more than welcome to join me, and hopefully it will help you to relax. How does that sound? Of course. Oh, well done you. Helping to feed the reindeers. Very good, very good, yes. They left about an hour ago now, didn't they? Yes, such a busy night. I often think it's more work for them than for him. And what with his new sat-nav, should be easier this year. Yes, it seems to give the quickest routes, so many, many happy faces on Christmas morning, which is lovely. Can I get you a mince pie? Perhaps. I baked them earlier today. They are actually little mini ones, or no offense meant at all, but probably more normal size to you. Yes, they are rather delightful, aren't they? Would you like one? I dusted a little bit of sugar over the top. There's a little bit just peeping out, just here. Are you sure I can't tempt you? Let me show you what they're like inside. Very, very light pastry, nice and crumbly, with a lovely mince pie interior. Are you sure I can't tempt you? Very well. I tell you what, I will pop and just get a little drop of sherry. Just wait here a moment. Are you sure I can't tempt you? Very well, very well. How about a little glass of syrup or maybe some hot chocolate? Yes, of course. There's just a fresh jug of the syrup, just there. That's the one. Yes, it is lovely, isn't it? Even though I don't quite have the same elf's taste, I do like a drop of syrup here and there. Oh, really? Oh, I must try that. The syrup over the turkey. Oh, it sounds lovely. It does. Me? Well, I haven't really asked for anything for Christmas. I hope I'm on the nice list. I have done a lot of charity work this year, and what with helping redo some of the elder elves' accommodation. That was very nice, the refurbishment. So, hopefully I've done enough to impress. But, you know, I don't really need anything. No. I mean, what would I like? Well, I suppose if anyone would know, my husband will, so we'll just have to wait and see in the morning. What about you though? Have you asked for anything in particular? Ah, yes, very nice. Oh, lovely. Well, I hope you get that. Yes, absolutely. I'm sure you must get bored of a lot of the toys that you see and make, so no, I think, you know, a drone is something different. Yes. And it would be quite nice to get some aerial views of the North Pole. Yes. I mean, really we should do some aerial photography in the next year. Yes, suggested to Santa many times that we put up a new website, you know. It's important to get online these days. And as I'm sure you know, so many of the elves now are starting to age, and whilst you live for at least a couple of hundred years, it's difficult to find new members, so I really think in the new year we'll have to start recruiting. Yes, and online really is the way forward. But anyway, enough about work. Now, let me just pop this down a moment. Ah, so you've done all your wrapping then. Well done. And all the family are okay? Good. So, why don't I help you to relax by reading you a little poem? Yes, I actually have a little book full of interesting things. Let me just get it a moment. Now where did I put Ah, yes, here we are. As you can see, it's been in the family for many generations. I love old books like this. I just think something about an old book that holds so much history. So let's have a little look and see what Christmas tales we have inside. How do you fancy a little reading of the poem A Visit from St. Nicholas by Clement Clark Moore? Yes? Perfect. Okay. So, are you ready, little one? Good. You've got enough blankets there? Good. You just relax and close your eyes if you want to. So, let's begin. 'Twas the night before Christmas, went all through the house. Not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap, when out on the lawn there arose such a clatter. I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below, when what to my wondering eyes did appear but a miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer, with a little old driver so lively and quick. I knew in a moment he must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, Now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with the sleigh full of toys and Saint Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney Saint Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him, in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside of his nose, and giving a nod up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." Well, wasn't that lovely? Bless you. You're very tired now. I know. I think it's the warmth of the fire as well, yes. Why don't you run along and get yourself all cozy in bed? Because you have a very big day ahead. You're welcome. And an early Merry Christmas to you. Thank you for all that you have done and do. I'll see you tomorrow. So, you better run along. I'll be here, just waiting for my husband to come home. Good night.